Ricky.
Yeah, good night. Three goals, clean sheet. Couldn't have asked for more, to be honest with you. Some good goals. I thought we played very well. Fought against a very good side in Everton. Some very good players. You know, they didn't come here under strength. They came here with their full squad, and obviously you saw that with the changes that they made as well. So, no, just a very, very good performance from ourselves.
This is a competition that a lot of clubs have given by a lot of the results tonight. A lot of Premier League clubs don't bother with. You've gone absolutely the opposite way with doing what the club did to get the full house crowd, and then what you've put in front of them with very few changes in your team.
Well, we made five changes to the starting lineup from last week, so we did make our changes, but it's a competition that's very important to us. I think you could see from the turnout tonight from our crowd just how important this competition is to them, and how important it is to myself and the team. And you know, we didn't want to disappoint. We wanted to go out there with the right attitude. We talked about that before the game, and obviously to try and get a positive result against a very good side in Everton with some very good players. And all in all, we delivered the performance that deserved the win that we got. Yeah, very good threat. The 1v1 situations that he had, and it's something that we targeted once we had the team sheets in. And I thought he delivered very well, very good performance, and looked very lively, looked very dangerous, looked like that's where our outlet came. Nathan as well, and obviously when Wayne come on to seal it up. But yeah, Jefferson performed very well tonight.
He's giving you a real selection headache ahead of the weekend, Garry, isn't he?
They all do. I know what I've got in the squad. I know all of them. I know what they can deliver. And, you know, look at Marvin when he come on, got his goal. And I know what they can all do. Thankfully, I've played with a lot of them, but even the ones that I haven't, I know what they can do. I've seen them every single day. So I said all along it'd be a squad effort this season. And you'll see as the season goes on, the squad will be used and what everyone can contribute.
The wide players are flying now, aren't they? All three of them, Gus.
Yeah, no, they are. And that's what happens when you can create competition. You know, I talked about it all through pre-season in terms of the numbers that I need to get in to make sure that every position has competition. And like I said, we're a couple short of that. But when you do have competition, you see what it is. And that creates that what you see there on the pitch. So as well as the training and the application that they give, which is something that's very important and something that we need to try and get to and maximise as soon as we can.
Lost the last two, Garry, but you didn't seem short on confidence at the team
at all. No, because the two that we lost, we performed very well in, especially the Southampton game. Circumstances dictated that result, I felt. But up until that period where we had the sending off, we were totally dominant. And the football that we're playing at the moment, hopefully we'll only get better. And I try and give the players as much confidence as possible when they go out there to play that way and not to worry about any mistakes, is to keep trying to play and improve that way. And I think tonight we did that. We did a couple of mistakes where we gave the ball away, but I think all in all, the performance that we gave was warranted the three goals and warranted the clean sheet.
It's a confidence boost, isn't it, going into Sunderland and finally beating Everton, the club that Swansea have never beaten?
Yeah, of course. And from my point of view, you know, when you have two losses in a row, albeit they've been very good performances and what they've been is, I tell the players that I worry about the results, not the players. You just get on with your day-to-day stuff and let me deal with it. But from my point of view is, if we, you know, you have two losses, if it's a third, it's then people start to talk, and even though you know nothing as much is wrong because you're doing well, you're training well, you're performing well, it's still the result is what people will look at. So I was very conscious of that, but so trying to relieve the pressure this last couple of days on the players to just worry about the performance, and they did that well today and stopped what was a massive losing run.
I know you'll say about the team, Garry, obviously, but on a personal level, is it a nice to get one over on Roberto?
Not so much. No, of course we owed him money. He had two over me last season, but I don't look at it like that. I just look at it as, you know, a chance for us to progress in the cup against a very good side. And, you know, I've got a lot of respect for Roberto. Obviously, the journey that he's been on, you know, I've witnessed it firsthand. And obviously to see him doing so well and with Everton and them in Europe and his career progressing, it'd be nice to try and aspire to something like that.
Is it realistic that Swansea can go and win this again?
We're not thinking that far ahead, really. You know, this round was this round, and I said it. My team talk before the game was them just to worry about today. Don't worry about tomorrow or the weekend or anything like that. Just worry about today, and that's all you can affect. So whatever will be in the next rounds, the next coming games. We've got games before that anyway. But the only thing I would say about the next round is probably trying to hopefully get a home draw, which is always nice. Well, you think it'd be nice, but especially for the travel element of it all. But We don't look that far ahead, to be honest.
You worry Roberto won't answer your calls anymore?
No, I've got a good relationship with Roberto. Graham, with him as well, Graham Jones, Dennis Lawrence, Richard Evans, and Iñaki, the goalkeeper coach. I've got a very good relationship with all of them. And, you know, we don't ring each other every day or anything like that, but, you know, I'm sure he's at the end of the phone when I need it. But I said before, you know, I'm a person that makes my own decisions, and then those guys, like him, Roberto and Brendan, are the ones that I'll make the decision, and if I thought that wasn't quite right, maybe I'll ask them then. But I don't ask them too many times. It's really, when I speak to them, it's a general chat about life, really, to be honest with you.
Because some talk today that Routledge might have a new contract.
Yeah, we're talking to Wayne and his representatives. You know, Wayne's, especially in my time here, but since his time at the club, I think he's found a home. You know, he's travelled around a lot. It's all well documented, but I think at Swansea he's found a home, somewhere where he can really be himself and perform at a very good level. And I can only talk from my time in terms of doing this, being a manager, when I took over in last season, was probably one of, if not the most consistent performer I had. And he's still continuing that into this season. So, you know, guys like that are valuable to me, and hopefully we can get that contract sorted as soon as possible.
Just